Take this time to focus your mind and heart on God and the redeeming grace and hope God offers us. God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in time of trouble. Therefore we will not fear, though the earth be moved, and though the mountains shake in the depths of the sea, though its waters rage and foam, and though the mountains tremble with its tumult. There is a river whose streams make glad the city of God, the holy habitation of the Most High. The nations rage and the kingdoms shake. God speaks and the earth melts away. Remember always, the Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our stronghold.
Opening prayer. God of love and grace, you surprise us by your presence. We are surrounded by your blessings. We are strengthened by your encouragement. Open our eyes to your presence here in our worship service. May we have ears to hear your message to us today. May we leave this time ready to serve you as we work to care for others and love you. In Christ's holy name we pray. Amen.
Even as we are separated physically and in our own homes, we are the church. Take this time to remember and even greet those of our church family and beyond. Take time to email, call, write cards to people, and greet them with genuine affection of Christian love, and pass along the peace of Christ in whatever creative way you might see possible.
This is the call to confession and prayer of confession. Take this time to look over your last week and notice times when you were not focused on God, times when fear overcame our trust and hope in you. Take this time to acknowledge how much we need God. In our prayer of confession, let us pray. Almighty God, we come to you in prayer. We would rather be in charge of our own lives than to allow you to lead us. We think we know how to find our own way, and we forget to look to you for direction. We wander around being led by so many things. Forgive us when we move away from you. Forgive us when we think we know it all and take off in directions that clearly are not good for us. We begin each day with great intentions, and then we get distracted from your leading. We fall short, and we need your care. We take this time to acknowledge that we need your guidance and mercy. We pray this in the name of Jesus. Amen.
A beautiful setting to remind us of God's assurance of pardon. Each week we pray that we ask God to forgive our sins, and each week we're reminded of God's grace and mercy. We are reminded that it is nothing that we do that assures our forgiveness. It is not because we are that great. It is because God is that great. So again today, let us remember that because of God's grace and mercy, we are assured of God's forgiveness. And this is the good news of Scripture. In Jesus Christ, we are forgiven. Thanks be to God.
We are free. about to read the word of the Lord. Listen for the word that stands the test of time. Listen for the word that lives and moves among us. Listen for the word that God is speaking to us this day.
Good morning. Before I start the scripture, I want to say that Norman and I miss all of you and love all of you and want you to stay safe and healthy until we meet again. And you're always in our prayers. Today's scripture comes from the book of Matthew, chapter 11, verses 16 through 19 and 25 through 30. To what can I compare this generation? They are like children sitting in the marketplaces and calling out to others. We played the flute for you and you did not dance. We sang a dirge and you did not mourn. For John came neither eating nor drinking, and they say, he has a demon. The Son of Man came eating and drinking, and they say, here is a glutton and a drunkard, a friend of tax collectors and sinners. But wisdom is proved right by her actions. At that time, Jesus said, I praise you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth, because you have hidden these things from the wise and learned and revealed them to the little children. Yes, Father, for this was your good pleasure. All things have been committed to me by my Father. No one knows the Son except the Father, and no one knows the Father except the Son, and those to whom the Son chooses to reveal him. Come to me, all you who are weary and burdened, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart. And you will find rest for your souls, for my yoke is easy and my burden is light.
Dear God, may your words be found in these words. May we take what you have for us to deepen us and strengthen us so that we might better serve you. We pray this in Jesus' name. Amen. So, I have so many things going on in my head right now, I don't know quite where to start. First, it is the 4th of July weekend, and I am exhausted from watching Hamilton 4 times. Finally, I turned on the captions so I know what they're saying. Such an interesting history that we come from. So much lament and so much hope. So many times when Jesus has lifted our burdens, taken the yoke from around our necks, and lightened that journey. I am so thankful for last week's service for the 6 people, Carl and Teresa and Julie and Dan and Margot and Tom, for your deep theological journey of where you have moved from lament to hope, where you see hope, where you have put your eyes on ways to see God working through times that have been difficult. I appreciated your words and I watched them several times. So thank you for that ministry, for offering and sharing. So this last week I was a commissioner to General Assembly, and the theme for General Assembly was moving from lament to hope. And we talked about that and probably experienced that through having a meeting with 700 people on Zoom, not being able to talk about issues because you can't do that on Zoom with 700 people, but still wanting to deal with some events that have happened over the past weeks and months that the Presbyterian Church needs to make a statement and make a stand on justice, a stand on loving kindness, a stand on walking humbly with God. And so there were issues that needed to be discussed that were kind of discussed as well as we could do that. So I have a portion of this time where there is a report from the 3 commissioners and kind of explaining to you or giving you an overview of what we do in General Assembly. It is a time when we meet every other year as a ruling body of the church represented by you, represented by elders, preaching elders, ruling elders in the church. We have representation from mission, from an ecumenical group, from young adults, from seminary students, and those are advisory committees, commissions, and they advise the commissioners how to vote on different issues. And it's a very interesting, very Robert's Rules of Order type of thing. So I have a portion of this time together that is a report from the three of us. Yesterday was the 4th of July. It brings a lot of emotion of the amazing strength of this country. And also with it brings how we can improve, always working to reform in our church, hopefully in our country. We're always working to notice what we've done that's been strong and notice where we can do better. Moving from lament, from times where we need to reevaluate and ask for forgiveness, repent, turn around, look at it from a different perspective, and be renewed, move into hope. In this time of self-quarantine, this time of spacing ourselves, we have times of sadness, times of lament. As we heard last week, this is a difficult time. But also, in the difficult time, we see people working to keep others safe, working to renew, working to use this time to clean out their houses, to work in your gardens, to read things you haven't read before, to think through some of the things that we have been doing that we need to reform. Looking at church, seeing what is valuable, who we are as a church, how we are working to reach out to others in this time of struggle. And then we come into this passage today, and we hear that in the midst of all of this, Jesus is here to lighten our burdens. Jesus is here to encourage us, to challenge us, to be the best we can be, because Jesus challenges us to do justice. Jesus challenges us to love our neighbors, even when they're not lovable, or even when we don't know them. But Jesus also says, through all of that challenge, Jesus says, I will carry you. When your burden is heavy, when your yoke is heavy, I will lift it. I will make it light. A yoke is something that is put around an oxen when oxen are working hard. And it is heavy, a heavy piece of wood that makes that oxen stay in a certain path. It is heavy. And I think that most of us have felt the heaviness of this time, the heaviness that has to do with our country, the heaviness that has to do with our health, the heaviness that has to do with relationships, the heaviness that comes from being separated, from not being able to give each other hugs, to not being able to sit around the table and eat with each other. And here is this passage this week that says, I will take your yoke upon me and I will make it light. We're reminded that at each month when we do communion. The words from this week's lectionary passage comes from our communion liturgy that Jesus says, I will lift your yoke. I will carry your burdens. Lean upon me. And I've been thinking of different ways that we might do that, different ways that we can notice when Jesus is there to lift us. For me, part of that carrying my burdens has been in working in my backyard, in watching things grow. I am not sitting on a small can in the middle of my garden like some person in our church. And I don't have a garden that's 2 miles wide, but in my little area, I, like Carl, can see God working. I heard clearly Margot saying that there are times of darkness, and I have also experienced that. Times of loneliness, times of not knowing what I can do as your pastor when I can't visit and I can't see you, but pray for you and work to try to be doing what it is that God has called me to do. So I think in the midst of all of this, when then I had to go to General Assembly at my own house and was confronted with what's going on in the world and how are we as the church to respond to that? How are we as the church to have ears to hear those who have cries out for help? How do we do that? With the understanding that we're not all going to do that the same way, but that we need to hear Jesus' voice telling us that we are to be kind to our neighbors, that we are to love our neighbors, even when we disagree with them. And so we have challenges, we have struggles, and we also have times when Jesus lightens our load, when Jesus shows us hope. When we move from lament, we did a word study, and you'll see that in our report from General Assembly, and also at the very end, you can see the word lament, and it's all lament at the beginning, and then it changes, and it changes a little bit to forgiveness or repentance, to look and see where we in our lament, in our sadness, how can we grow from that? And then there are a couple words that indicate that there are cries, and the next word, cloud, has words like renew, and all of these word clouds then move into the final word cloud, which the center large word is love. And we have moved from lament being the center word to the word love being the center word, and it didn't jump from one to the other. We moved through a process of repentance and forgiveness and acknowledging and renewing, turning and looking at things in a new way, and acceptance of that renewal into a hope, into a love. And so we see from the word clouds that are in later in the service, you could see that process of moving from lament into moving through struggles, moving through times of discouragement, but moving into times of hope, which comes through in God's love. And Jesus assures us this week through communion and through scripture that Jesus will carry us, that Jesus makes our burdens light. And we don't want to miss that. Where are there times when Jesus is carrying us? Where are there times when Jesus makes our burdens light and we don't even notice? Little times throughout the days, I've been trying to write down where I've seen God each day and trying to do that throughout the day. And then making that into a prayer journal, thanking God, asking God for help. And in that process, I can see God's care. I can see, and sometimes I can feel Jesus lifting that yoke from my shoulders that get sore or tired and stressed out. Times when we are lifted. And I think it takes the journey, and it takes the discipline to try to identify and acknowledge
times that we struggle, and identify and acknowledge times when Jesus lifts our yoke, maybe through others, maybe through music, maybe through sunlight, maybe through rain, maybe through our children, our grandchildren, maybe through parents, maybe through people in our lives who have made a difference that out of the blue send us a note on Facebook and say, I remember when, and it reminds you that you are a part of their life and that they are a part of yours. So Jesus lifts our yoke and carries us, lifts our burdens in a number of different ways. So as we go through this next week, be aware of times when Jesus carries us, when we feel that we're not going to be able to get through the day, and something happens that encourages us and lifts our burdens, both as individuals, as a country, as a church, as a community. So let's close remembering the hope that we have in Jesus, the hope that we have through communion, that Jesus forgives us, that Jesus encourages us, not after we become perfect, not after we become sinless, but while we were yet sinners, we were forgiven, and Jesus offered us this salvation and this hope. So as we begin communion, let's keep that in mind, and let's hear the words that our Lord Jesus offered. Amen. Before we begin communion, I would like to present to you a video that we made that I thought would be good for you to see. And it is from the three commissioners from Lake Erie Presbytery. So I think I'd like to do that now. And when that's complete, we will begin our communion service.
Russell. I was commissioner for the 224th General Assembly, labeled or named from Lament to Hope.
Hi, this is Bryce Preston. I am from Pleasantville, and I was the Young Adult Advisory Delegate from Lake Erie Presbytery to this year's General Assembly.
Greetings from General Assembly, which looks amazingly like the office in my house.
When Laura and Ronnie and I were elected last fall, we were so excited to go to Baltimore to be at this gathering of Presbyterians from across the country and around the world. But late this spring, as with so many other plans, we learned that General Assembly would have to be online this year because it wouldn't have been wise to meet in person, and because the convention center where we were supposed to meet in Baltimore had been converted into a field hospital to treat COVID-19 patients.
So this is the year that we did our homework and we did not go on the field trip. We had a special situation for us this year, and that was that we were going to meet remotely. We were going to sit and look at Zoom for 2 straight days.
So with this change came the opportunity to learn a little bit about technology. So for the past 4 or 5 assemblies, the General Assembly has voted on the Presbyterian website called PC Biz. And on PC Biz, we can easily see the overture that was being brought before the assembly. We could read all about it right in the same webpage. And then we could vote, and we would instantly see the results of the vote that we had just done, both in a chart or a table and in a bar graph. So we each had that on one screen, and we each had a second screen where we could see the Zoom meeting, so we could see the moderators, the other delegates, or the videos that were being shown to us.
So that we didn't completely miss our opportunity, the three of us from Lake Erie Presbytery decided that we would meet together. So we have been meeting here at my home, and that has been lovely.
We had so much fun at Ronnie's house. We ate together, we got to talk about the votes together, we got to play with pets together, and we just had a great time.
As we began our adventure through a unique, awesome, and humbling experience, service leaders representing many different ethnic backgrounds from the four corners of the United States and Zoom choirs from the Baltimore area, lamented about what has been happening in the world over the past several months and asking God for his strength, love, and hope. During Bible study, we took a closer look at Lamentations chapter 5, verses 20 and 21, which is basically asking why has God forgotten us and asking to be restored to him. And then we discussed our concerns over the past few months. We were taught that through lamenting, we can repent. And once we repent, we can take action, and through action, move into hope.
So some things that I want to take from this General Assembly, things I want to share with you, is that we were reminded once again that the church is not our buildings, that we are the church, that we are here to share the love of Jesus, and we do that by loving kindness, by doing justice, by walking humbly with our God. And that is the good news, that the church is not dying, but the church is reforming. Our stated clerk, J. Herbert Nelson, mentioned that we are stirred by the Spirit, and that congregations are the straws that stir the drink, that we are here for such a time as this, that we do have a purpose, and we are reforming.
As we continue to praise God, outgoing moderators Bill Marie and Cindy progress from lamenting the events of the past few months to repenting our actions and reactions and encouraging us to make decisions during General Assembly so that we can finally turn to hope in what God can provide for us. God can accomplish far more than we can imagine and fill us with power, strength, and perseverance.
So it was interesting to spend time doing a lot of polity, and it was interesting to see people from across the country as they agreed by going like this, and we worshiped and we prayed together. One of the most inspirational parts of this General Assembly for me was the election of the two co-moderators, Gregory Bentley, who is an African-American pastor from Alabama, and Leona Street Stewart, who is Native American from Lakes and Prairies. She works on the synod level. And to hear their story and to hear their voices was inspirational, and I think will be for the next 2 years, that we have opportunity to hear some voice of people groups who have gone through things that many of us have not gone through, and help guide us into how we can have a more just church, a more just society, how we can live into the call of Jesus to love God and to love our neighbor. And what is our neighbor, and how does that look?
As we closed our meeting, we meditated over events, decisions, and hope, and praised God for all he can give us. We focused on the current problems of the world and asked for God's forgiveness so that we could boldly take action to deal with these problems and thus create hope and a better future for all.
So that was the inspirational part of this, the hopeful part of this, dealing with a loss and watching it move to hope. Thank you. Join me as we come together around the table. Jesus said, "Come to me, all who are weary and carrying heavy burdens, for I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart, and you will find rest for your soul. I am the bread of life. Whoever comes to me will never be hungry. Whoever believes in me will never be thirsty. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be blessed." Our invitation to the table. Jesus Christ, our Lord, invites to his table all who love him, who earnestly repent of their sins, and seek to live in peace with one another. Therefore, let us now take this time to confess our sins to God and to one another. Let us pray. Merciful God, we confess that we have not loved you with our whole heart. We have failed to be an obedient church, and we have not done your will. We have broken your law, we have rebelled against your love, and we have not loved our neighbors. We have not heard the cry of the needy. Forgive us, we pray. Free us for joyful obedience through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Here is the good news. Jesus died for us while we were yet sinners. While we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. And that proves the love of Almighty God. In the name of Jesus Christ, we are forgiven. Thanks be to God. Amen. We give thanks that the Lord Jesus Christ, on the night before he died, he took the bread, and after giving thanks, he broke it, and he said, "Take, eat. This is my body broken for you." And then he took the cup, and he poured from the cup, and he said, "This is my blood shed for the forgiveness of sins." Now, whenever you eat this bread or drink from this cup, do this in remembrance of me. We will take a time now of quiet meditation as you pour the cup and break the bread and use these elements as a remembrance of all that Christ has done for you. We will go to a time of music, of quiet reflection, while you participate and share around the table.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Glorious God, pour out your Holy Spirit upon us and upon these your gifts of bread and juice, that the bread we break and the cup we bless might be the communion of the body and blood of Christ. By your Spirit, make us one with Christ, that we might be one with all who share in this feast, united in ministry in every place around the world. As this bread is Christ's body for us, send us out to be the body of Christ in the world. We pray this in Jesus' name. Amen.
Take this quiet time to pray in your home. Write names of people to pray for during the next week. Please remember people from the congregation who are sick or struggling. Remember to thank God for all that we have, and pray for those having a difficult time in life right now. We continue to pray for Wendell Sowers and Don Weaver, for Frank and for JR. We pray for Zach and Allie and their new baby coming, as well as Megan and Nate Carl and their new baby coming. We remember to pray for essential workers, families, our country, those with illness, those struggling with economic challenges, people who feel afraid and alone, the helpers, the church in the world, those in our church family who are struggling, people who feel left out, those who are discouraged and disenfranchised. Help them to know you are strength and hope. People giving out Christ's call to serve and care for others as we move into the world with God's message of care and love. Take time to thank God for the many blessings in your life.
As we leave this time together, go now knowing that Jesus carries us, that when our yoke is heavy, when our burdens are heavy, that Jesus lifts, that Jesus encourages, that Jesus is our strength. So as we move from lament to hope in our lives. Let us do that knowing that Jesus assures us that he is with us, that he loves us, that he carries us. So go out now, go into the world, love kindness, do justice, and walk humbly with your God. Amen.